Recently, we made a video on the first ever production jet fighter, the iconic German Messerschmitt 262. It's hard to overstate the importance of that aircraft. But just a few months into its service, it already had a proper rival. In July 1944, the Royal Air Force were already using the Gloster Meteor, subsequently the only jet aircraft on the Allied side that saw actual use in combat during the war. The story of the development of this aircraft is just as spectacular. The key role in the creation of the Meteor was played by Frank Whittle, an Air Force officer who, from 1930 onwards, spent more than 10 years developing his groundbreaking turbojet engine. Renowned scientists and engineers were highly critical of his work for years, and Whittle was nearly driven to abandon the project several times due to lack of funding. By 1940, though, the engine showed enough promise for Whittle to partner up with Gloster Aircraft to finally work on a new fighter for the Air Ministry. Gloster designers settled on a conventional straight-wing monoplane design. Having tested the capabilities of the single-engine Gloster Pioneer, they decided that their new aircraft would be powered by a pair of turbojet engines housed in nacelles. The aircraft was also to feature an armament of 6 20mm Hispano Mark V cannons, but due to problems with their placement, 2 of those cannons were eliminated on the road to production. After most teething problems had been solved, the Meteor was finally accepted into service. The earliest F Mark I variant saw only limited production and was used primarily as a trainer aircraft. The first truly mass-produced Meteor was the F Mark III. In War Thunder, this aircraft is fitted with Darwent turbojets, outputting 907 kilograms of thrust. In comparison with the German Schwalbe, this Meteor is better at getting up to speed and has better turning performance in level flight, on par with piston engine aircraft. Another thing distinguishing the Meteor from its counterparts was its armament configuration. The ME-262 is well known for its powerful 30mm Machine Kanon 108 cannons and their pretty limited ammo reserves. In contrast, the Meteor was armed with less punchy 20mm guns, but carried more ammunition, 780 rounds, 3 times more. In other words, both aircraft had a trick or two up their sleeves, but they were not fated to meet in combat. The British initially used their Meteors only to counter the V-1 flying bomb threat and to provide air defense. Meteors were used offensively only at the very late stage of the war, where they got to fight a few AR-234s while flying armed reconnaissance and ground attack operations. So there's that. In 1945, with the arrival of a much more powerful Darwin V engine, it became apparent that at a speed of around 850 kph or higher, the aircraft suffered from serious stability problems. This obstacle was resolved by giving the aircraft a longer fuselage. The new model, called Meteor F Mark IV, was produced in 2 variations, the G-41F with a longer wing and the G-41G, which came later and had shorter wings to account for an increase in stress on the wings at higher speed. At some point, Meteors were also considered for conversion into naval aircraft. In 1948, a few vehicles were modified to have a lighter airframe and were also fitted with arrestor hooks and upgraded engines. Those few aircraft, known as the C Meteor F Mark III, went through a series of trials, including carrier landings and takeoffs. In the end, though, the project was deemed unsuccessful. Finally, the very same year was when the last mass-produced variant of the Meteor was introduced, the Meteor F Mark VIII. The wing structure was reinforced with additional alloy steels used in the framework, and the nacelle structure was modified yet again to improve access. The Mark 8 is easily recognizable because of its new tail assembly, taken from the E-144 experimental fighter aircraft, and that wasn't all. The Mark 8 also got a new powerful Derwent 8 engine, producing 1,630 kilograms of thrust. Meteors of the Royal Australian Air Force took part in the Korean War, where they had to fight with MiG-15s. That experience highlighted the fact that, by that point, the British fighter, though still capable, couldn't really compete with more modern fighter aircraft. As a result, Gloster engineers tried to modify it for ground attack by giving it the ability to carry an increased payload, with even more RP-3 rockets or 1,000-pound bombs, in an effort that led to the creation of the Meteor F Mark 8 Reaper variant. It's available in War Thunder as a premium vehicle, but in real life, this experimental model never made it into production. Meteors saw it all. An ideal testbed for a variety of products which followed it, Meteors were used as attack aircraft by the armies of Israel, Argentina, and many other countries, while the British simply used them for almost anything. Target towing, testing new ideas and technologies, as trainer aircraft, you name it. And even though a Meteor never fought a Schwalbe, the work of one Frank Whittle had a lasting influence on the development of aircraft in Germany, the US, and the USSR. So, what is your favorite Meteor? One of the experimental models, or maybe one of the good old regular Meteors? Please, guys, tell us in the comments below.